Hey there, Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja, and I got Brian here from Aprilaire again. He's sitting down with me, and today we're going to be talking about how humidity affects temperature, and also how much does it cost to run a dehumidifier. So stay tuned. Okay, Brian, first of all, I want to say I like your, I don't know if that's on camera, but that's a wonderful Crawl Space Ninja mug, and you know, we're gonna let you take that with you. He needs to be dehumidified. He just got some water on his shirt. So anyway, let's get into our subject. We're gonna talk about, you know, I read on your website, and it's a great website, by the way. Aprilaire.com, is that right?
Yep, Aprilaire.com.
Now, of course, you can't purchase from the website.
That's correct. You
will be sent to dealers or distributors in their area. But why would you want to purchase anywhere but CrawlSpaceNinja.com? I have no idea. But anyway, we want to talk about a little bit about how the humidity affects how I feel.
Sure.
Okay? And not emotionally how I feel, but temperature-wise how I feel. So can you share that with us?
Absolutely. So when the humidity is in the air, we call that a latent load. So that's basically, latent means hidden. That's the hidden part of what's going on inside of your house. And when you have moisture, it's a lot more uncomfortable. And the analogy I like to use is, if you've ever been to Phoenix, Arizona, or Palm Springs in California, you'll notice that it can be 100 degrees outside, and you can be out on the golf course or swimming, and it's extremely comfortable. Because when you don't have that extra moisture or humidity in the air, your body's very efficient at evaporating and cooling yourself. But when you add all that extra moisture and extra humidity, it becomes uncomfortable. And in essence, it feels like it's hotter and more miserable than it actually is.
That's a good point. That's a good point. And I use the opposite from whenever it's cold here in Knoxville. It can be 30 degrees outside or just under freezing, and then it feels super cold. It's like what we call bone chilling cold. But I had the pleasure to go out to Colorado and stay a few days, and it was like negative 12 degrees. And don't get me wrong, it was cold, but it didn't feel cold. And it was just amazing, the temperature difference and how humidity affect, you know, a 20 degree or a 20% relative humidity in Colorado versus an 80% relative humidity here in Knoxville. So that was a wonderful analogy.
You know, Michael, that's why you ever hear the weather guy on TV when they'll tell you, hey, it's 80 degrees outside, but it feels like 88.
That's why they tell you that.
It's the heat index.
Right.
It's the role that humidity plays on making it feel hotter than it actually is.
That's great. I hope that helps. So the other thing we want to talk about is, I get a question all the time. Well, if I install a dehumidifier, how much is that going to cost me every month on my utility bills? Do you mind sharing with that a little bit?
Absolutely. So obviously, depending on your kilowatt hour rate in your different jurisdictions, that can change. But from what we found in a seasonal average is, when a person runs a dehumidifier, it's going to be about a $10 to $15 cost per month from what we've seen empirically for a dehumidifier. However, there's some benefits that now you can raise your thermostat up. So let's say you had it at 68 degrees in the summer before your dehumidifier. If you raise it up to, say, 74, it's a rule of thumb that for every degree that you raise your temperature, it's a 1% savings on your energy bill. So that's a 6% savings monthly that will offset that $10 to $15. So again, having a dehumidifier and having that comfort and healthy area now is not really going to cost you that much money month over month.
That's right. And $10 to $15 a month versus having a mold problem inside your house is also a great benefit. So we obviously don't want, because a lot of people forget, the only reason why we fix crawl spaces, you know, ultimately is because of structural issues, or to protect the home from structural issues, or to protect indoor air quality inside of the home, since 50% of the air in the crawl space makes its way into the living space. So if you can control humidity down there and create a better indoor air quality environment, there's hidden benefits there that could save you hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars every year. The other thing that I'd like to ask you about is, you know, is it also true that the AC runs more efficient when the house humidity is lower? Is that also correct?
Absolutely, because before we were talking about the latent versus sensible loads. And again, sensible is the straight temperature. That's the temperature of dry air, where that latent is what happens when you have that humidity in there. It's much more difficult for an HVAC system to cool, because guys, first it has to remove that moisture
right
from the air, and then the temperature is brought down. Whereas when you have a drier air going into the HVAC system, it's much easier and takes less energy to just reduce that temperature.
That's right. So that's another energy savings benefit.
That's correct.
And of course, the Aprilaire 1820, 1830, and 1850, which we offer on the DIY page, they're all Energy Star rated. So they're running at maximum efficiency already. Is that correct?
Yes. The 1820 and 1830 are Energy Star rated. The 1850 is not.
Oh, well, there you go. I didn't
know. However, again, we always talk about the energy factor. It's still designed to optimize and run efficiently. So we always like to compare it to, you know, the Energy Star portable that you might see at your big box store. And from the research and data we've gathered, you're going to save about $189 if you're running our dehumidifiers when you compare it to your typical portable, because it's going to run optimized, it's going to run longer cycles, and it's not going to have nearly the number of hard compressor starts that you would get from a big box store dehumidifier.
That's great.
So you're still going to get that energy savings that you're looking for.
That's great. Is that research you're talking about on your website, aprilaire.com?
You can find it in all of our literature, which again, you can find that on aprilaire.com as well.
Well, we'll put a link to that down below, so that way you got access to that straight to the Aprilaire website, or maybe I'll even write a blog and kind of get that information and put it on Crawlspace Ninja. So anyway, really appreciate you coming, Brian, and it's been a pleasure talking to you. And I hope you like this video, and we're going to put some links down below to all these topics. And we've already done a couple of other videos about the different remotes and the comparisons between the three Aprilaire models that we offer on the DIY page. We're going to put those links down below as well. And my name is Michael Church with Brian Canfield from Aprilaire, and we hope you make it a happy and blessed day. And thanks for watching. We'll see you later.